Hi, welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Alice Ritter, and today's tutorial is going to be about color coding of Z-Stack images. I'm going to show you how to use imageJ to perform color coding of your Z-Stack images. And today's tutorial was inspired by a tweet from Andy. He shared this beautiful microscope image on Twitter, and you can see this elegant microscope image. It has more information to tell you with this image. And what do I mean by the image carries more information? If you look at this microscope image, you can see that some objects were localized to red, some looks cyan in color, some in green. And because he has color-coded this the sample, the different color indicates the different position that this structures were within the Z-Stack images. And when I saw this tutorial, when I saw this tweet, immediately I put this down in my to-do list that my next image tutorial would be how to color code a Z-Stack image with imageJ. And today, while I'm recording the tutorial, I check for more tweet on Twitter, and you can also see this arbuscular fungi. The arbuscular fungi has been color coded to show the different nucleus, because this particular arbuscus has several nucleus within its arbuscus, and the different color is showing the different positions where this nuclei we're within the Z-Stack image. And also there's another one I found from Journal of Cell Biology. You can also see this fibroblast cell. You can see that the different structure of this fibroblast cell are at different position within the Z-Stack. And that's why you could see some in orange, green, white, purple, and several other colors that you can see. So don't worry, you are not going to be left out, because today I'm feeling generous to show you how to carry out this an analysis. So please, if you are new and you've not subscribed to my channel, please click the subscribe button. If you need help with analysis or any part of imageJ that you are having trouble executing, leave your comment in the comment section. I'm going to read them and offer you some guidance if I know how to do what you need to do. So in order to be able to do this analysis, you need one sample. And which type of sample is that? You need a sample that is having three dimension, meaning you've captured it at the microscope in an XYZ or XYZT position. So this one here is my sample that I've color coded. You can see how beautiful it is. And this is the original image, the green and the bright field image. So when you open your microscope image at the imageJ, the two channels will be together. So the first thing you need to do is to go to image, color, split channels. This will split the different channel into individual channel. So if you have three channels together, it will split it into three. And if you have two channels like I do here, you are going to be having your two different channels in different window. But for today analysis, we do not need a bright field image, because we want to see it's our fluorescence image that we want to color code. And why is it important that you use color coding? It's not important. It's just that if you want to get an extra information from your sample, then you can use the color coding function. You can see I'm going to play this Z-Stack, and you can see that the objects that my sample is localized to is at different Z-Stack position. So when we put this, normally what we do in order to show the sample is normally putting it into a maximum projection, which will just show the whole objects in a 2D representation. And you can see these are my objects projected into a 2D format. And what we want to do is to see the location of each of these puncta in our Z stack. So you go to plugins, stacks. You can use the, there are two color coding options with this in this plugin. You can either use this K time RGB color code or time lapse color coder. So if you use the, I'm going to be using the two different one, and then you can see what you can see the different thing that they do. They perform similar function, just that one of them have an extra function which you might be interested in. So if you click on this time lapse color coder, it's going to ask you which color format you want to project your color coding. It's not advisable to choose a gray color because this will just show you the different shades of gray. And by different shades of gray, I mean it will show, okay, I'm going to do this and then you can see what I mean. You see, when I selected the grays function, the grays color coding, it gave me a scale bar that is from dark to light. And if you look at this sample, you can also see that some are brighter, like the white one, are closer to the base of the image. But you can easily lose your audience because, like this one that is showing a bit in between dark and white, you can see it's difficult to see this actual image. So it's not advisable to choose gray's scale for your scale bar. So I'm going to repeat this process by going to Stacks, Time-Lapse Color Coder, and I'm going to be choosing Spectrum. If you select Spectrum, this will allow you to have your samples displayed in different colors. So it's going to be choosing all sorts of colors. And when you click OK, you can see that now I'm moving from far red, from orange to red, and the other colors in between. And you can see that this, my beautiful sample, is showing the different location that the puncta, this, can you see this particular structure? This smaller one is this cyan color. It's at the middle of my Z-stack image. And this other one here, it's towards the base. So this is why it's important to use a color coding. You get more information apart from just showing your the objects of your within the 3D. So what about the second color coding option that I showed you earlier? What does it do? And what extra function does it have? So I'm going to put this here with this scale. So we're going to go to plugins again, stacks, K time RGB color coder. This function would give you two types of window. One is it will generate a different Z-stack image with a different color coding depth. And at the same time, it will generate the 2D, like the one that we already have that we did just a few seconds ago. So if I click OK, you can see that it's generated several windows. The first one is the one that shows the depth, the position of my objects within the Z-stacks here. And the second one it's generated is a new Z-stack image that shows the different look, can you see the color changing as I drag this? Okay, let's play it. You can see the color changing in the Z-stack. And with this, you can decide that, okay, you want to show the one that are showing this particular color. So if I drag this, you can see the different color within the Z-stacks. So you can put this into montage so that you can see the different, if you want to count the number of objects within the particular position, you can then use the montage function because it will split them into stacks, make montage. So this way splits the image into the different color depths that it has generated. So look at that. So you can see that this different image is at the different Z-stack position and it has generated the color from the darkest red to the lightest orange to yellow, like that. So that's the extra function that this function has. If you do not need the extra information, you can just use the time-lapse color coder or use this. If you have this one, it's nice because you can still make a maximum projection from it. Just go into image, stacks, make maximum projection. That's Z project. So you can see this also still end up giving us this, just as an extra step further if you want to save if you want to save the Z-Stack and play it as a video. You can easily use the one that has the extra K function. So I hope today's tutorial is useful to you. If you find it useful, please subscribe, please like this video, and please comment in the comment section if you are interested in me showing you how to do another to guide you in another way, or if you have other tutorial that you would like me to carry out next, please leave it in the comment section. And until next time, I remain Alice Ritter. Have a lovely day. Bye.